Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Tuesday morning. My name is Stephen Whiteside from theuptrend.com with today's look at U.S. stock market trends. Well, yesterday was a historic day for the market, a lot of short covering, first trading day of the month, a lot of stuff going on. This morning, the futures have been all over the place. They're currently flat. 10 minutes ago, the Dow was up 150. 20 minutes ago, the Dow was negative. Right now, it is flat. So far, I have no idea how the market's going to open on Tuesday morning. The VIX came down yesterday, still not enough for a sell signal. We talked about locking in profits on a long VIX position on the weekend. For those of you who aren't following our charts and who aren't taking money off the table on a regular basis, we need to close below 23.13 on Tuesday to give us a sell signal. That, of course, would be supportive for higher stock prices. Now, a lot of people are anticipating that the Fed gets together with other central banks this week and lowers interest rates, and that could be a buy the rumor, which we saw yesterday, a sell the news type situation. So just be aware of that. Speaking of interest rates, we saw the TLT make a new high yesterday, hit the top of our projected trading range on the daily charts of 156.25, traded through that yesterday, and reversed. That reversal gave us a bearish reversal signal, but it wasn't enough to give us a new early warning signal on the panic zone chart. So here we are coming off a new high yesterday. We need to close below 148.75 on Tuesday to give us a sell signal for the TLT, not expecting that to happen. And of course, that lower channel line is going to continue to move higher daily. Next up, let's walk through the ETF volume leaders from Monday's trading action. And one of the things you're going to notice is we're not going to see anybody close above Thursday's high in this group. So starting with the Spider ETF, we've got a ways to go before we get near a buy signal. And of course, that upper channel line is going to continue to move lower daily. Then we're looking at emerging markets, no change there. Then we're looking at financials. The Spider ETF for the financials did not come near the Thursday high. Then the Qs. The Qs for the NASDAQ 100 closed right at the Thursday high. And so we still have a ways to go before a buy signal, but certainly there is still that love for the high-tech NASDAQ stocks that everybody loves so much. Then the VXX came down yesterday. On the weekend, I recommended you take money off the table. On Monday morning, if you weren't already taking money off the table, you had a chance, several chances to take money off the table on the way up. We hit $25 on Thursday, got some emails from people who got filled up there, and then it started to pull back. So congratulations for those people long the VIX. Then looking at the gold stocks with the GDX, we traded up into the gap yesterday, so no joy there. Then moving on, looking at the EFA, we traded up into the range, Thursday's range, didn't get near the top of the range. Then looking at the SQQs, we've had several opportunities to take money off the table here, came down hard yesterday into the channel. So a close below 18.89 would kick us out of the remainder of our position. You had a chance to take money off the table at $21.88 and $25, so you should just have a partial position left. Then looking at the EYG, this is corporate bonds. Certainly there's an interest in corporate bonds at the moment, and we traded right up to Thursday's high. Then looking at oil and gas exploration, the XOP, the iShares or the Spider ETF, we traded through the Thursday's high, didn't close above it, so a little interest there, but we're still ways from a buy signal on Tuesday morning. Then looking at the Brazilian stock market, the Brazilian iShares traded right up to Thursday's high, did not break through. Let's finish off looking at the FANG stock, starting with Facebook, trading up to Thursday's high and closing. Then Apple Computer rushing all the way back into the channel, so a close above 305.29 would give us a new buy signal on Tuesday. But notice that we're trading up towards the bottom of an open gap. That bottom of the open gap could act as resistance for Apple. Then looking at Amazon, trading up into Thursday's range. Then Netflix, of course, if we're all going to be sequestered at home and nobody can go out, what are you going to do? You're going to watch Netflix. We're still on a sell signal right now, but just a dollar away from a buy signal on Tuesday. Close about 382.13 would give us a buy signal on Tuesday for Netflix. Then looking at Google, trading up past Thursday's high, getting close to the lower channel line. And then last up, we're looking at Tesla. We need to close above 814.70 on Tuesday to give us a new buy signal for Tesla. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Should be another wild day. Next time you'll hear my voice is on a Wednesday morning, and at that time we'll take a closer look at the Canadian stock market.